Hi and welcome back to Doc Off Call. My name's Maddie, I'm a doctor working in the UK. In today's video we're going to be responding to a viewer's request for me to review and explain the science in a recent anime show called Dr. Stone. Now, before this was actually recommended, I'd actually watched this whole anime, and it's a really good show. So the story basically follows a story of Senko, who along with the world were turned to stone for thousands of years for an unknown reason. Now, when Senko reawakens, he finds that the world has regressed back to the Stone Age, and all of man's science and technology is now lost to time. And it's his role as a scientist now to rediscover all of those discoveries that man had before and bring them back into the current day. Now, the scene we're going to be looking at today is how he's rediscovering antibiotics. Okay, let's watch. That's pretty cool. Okay, already, you know, I can learn a thing or two about branding from him, you know, his name, Dr. Stone, coming up in the big lights. But that's pretty cool. Alright, cool. So he's now just sort of walking in the forest, looking a bit like a badass. Yeah, I mean, that's what I like about animation as well. Did you see how crazy his hair is and the colour? I've never seen anyone hair like that or coloured hair like that, other than sort of cosplayers. Alright, so I guess this guy here is his like sort of laboratory assistant. He's got all of those sort of familiar sort of bits of equipment, the beakers and things like that. Okay, so yeah, this is our first sort of character that we're seeing here. It's Ruri, and from what we know from previous episodes, she's troubled by this long-term disease affecting her lungs, and we often see her breathless. We've sometimes seen her coughing up blood. She's looked to be sort of sweaty and clammy and sort of tired and fatigued most of the time. Now, the things that are going through my mind as to what could be causing this are sort of chronic or long-term lung diseases, and one of the categories that's coming to mind with these fevers is whether it's sort of a chronic infection, and I would be thinking about things like tuberculosis. So yeah, tuberculosis is a bacterial infection that mainly affects the lungs, but it can affect other parts of the body like the tummy. It can also affect the bones as well as nerves. And it's still around today, and it can be treated with antibiotics, and so I guess that's what Senko's going to be making in today's episode.
Oshiete kure, Senko! Bannou yaku no tsukurikata o yo! Ruri no byouki buttaoshite yaru ze!
Ruri nee ga naoru no nara ba, donna kyouryoku demo suru zo!
Okay, so these two little side characters here, I really like their enthusiasm about finding a cure for this and really trying to give it their all. And being a trainer of medical students and junior doctors, you do see that a lot within the junior staff, and they're really keen to actually implement what they've learned at medical school, and they're really capturing it well here.
俺ら科学王国が作るのは抗生物質。人に取り付いた細菌をぶっ潰す科学の万能薬だ。 20世紀初頭に発見されて以来、人類何億人もの命を救ってきた。
Yeah, I think that's true. You know, antibiotics really did revolutionize the science of medicine, and who knows how many lives have been saved by us having them. You know, I would hesitate to guess, but as a minimum, you're looking at the millions. You know, prior to us having antibiotics, one of the leading causes of death was infections worldwide. And that was reflected in the life expectancy of people. You know, prior to the 20th century, your life expectancy was about 50. But now coming to the latter part of the 21st century, it's around 80. So, you know, people aren't dying so much of infections. They're dying of more sort of old age or cancers or other medical illnesses.
血液検査もできねえ、病名もわかりゃしねえ。それでも飲ましてみる価値はある。
Yeah, so that's true. I mean, nowadays we have the luxury of having blood tests, and we can do things like blood cultures, where we can send off the blood test to find out what specific bacteria is causing the infection. I mean, you can do that with other samples as well, whether it's sputum, urine, or any other essential fluid within the body. And after a couple of days, you can get a result back telling you what the bacterial cause of the infection might be. Now, what we tend to do is, if someone's really poorly with an infection, we'll get all those samples sent away so that the lab can start processing them. But in the meantime, we'll hit you with one of our strongest antibiotics to keep you alive until we actually find out what the bacterial cause is, and then we can narrow down the antibiotic to something more specific that's going to treat that bacteria alone.
万能薬作るルートはざっくり2つ。生き物からペニシリンを作るバイオルートと、石からサルファ剤を作るストーンルートだ。
待ってくれセン君、生き物、石、それがどう薬になるんだ？
Yep, so I mean, surprisingly, a lot of our medicines are actually derived from natural sources. An example being something like aspirin, which is actually derived from the bark of a willow tree, or otherwise you have things like digoxin, which is a medication that's used for the heart. It's actually derived from the foxglove plant. So there are actually quite a few medicines that are derived from natural products. They're not all just synthetic and made in a lab.
になるんだ。
有名なのは青カビで作るペニシリンだな。ただペニシリンのバイオルートで肝心な青カビはこのストーンワールドじゃなぜか偶然100億倍パワーのスーパー青カビを見つけたぜ。ウェイッツ、超ラッキーに期待する運ゲーだ。
ウェイ、
神様、ナイスな青カビください、お願いしますって祈り続けるしかね。
So, I like how they've depicted penicillin in this video as this green mold. And it's funny because in the story of penicillin's discovery, that is what it looked like. And penicillin was actually discovered by accident. So the story goes that Alexander Fleming, who was working as a lab assistant at the time, was performing various lab tests, and he'd left a petri dish by an open window, and he'd left it there for a period of time, and it had some bacteria in it. Anyway, later, after a couple of days, he stumbled across this petri dish, and what he noted was that some mold had begun to grow on it, and what he could see was that the bacteria surrounding this mold had actually all died. And what he extrapolated from that was that there was something within the mold that was killing the bacteria. And he later isolated penicillin from this mold. And we've been using penicillin as an antibiotic since.
逆にサルファ剤のストーンルートは死ぬほど根気と人手がいるが、この石だらけの世界でも100億%必ず万能薬にたどり着ける。だったら答えはもう決まってるぜ。
Okay, so rather than waiting around to discover penicillin, what they're choosing to do is go down an alternative pathway and try to create a synthetic antimicrobial, and they're going to do this making a sulfur-based antibiotic. So sulfur-based antibiotics actually preceded penicillin. However, sulfur-based antibiotics were a lot more harsh on the body. They caused a lot more side effects, and they were a lot less sort of tolerated by the people that used them. Also, another problem with the sulfur-based antibiotics were that they developed antibiotic resistance pretty quickly. And whereas penicillin was a bactericidal antibiotic, so it actually killed the bacteria, sulfur-based antibiotics are bacteriostatic, so they just cause a halt in the growth of the bacteria rather than killing it. Now, we still do use some sulfur-based antibiotics. We commonly use them in prescribing for things like water infections or preventing infections developing within burns, but they've now been superseded by more penicillin-based antibiotics, just due to the side effect profile.
わかってんじゃねえか、クローム。俺らは神様でも天才でもねえ。一歩ずつ一歩ずつ地べた這いずり回って作ってくんだよ。
Yeah, that's true. So, I mean, that's really captured well the philosophy of medicine and evidence-based medicine. So in medicine, we always try to practice evidence-based medicine. So we're only giving you treatments that we know have a proven benefit to spare you from the side effects. And that evidence base is constantly being built on by new discoveries that allow us to give more refined treatments and help minimize any harm to our patients. And this is what I really like about this show. You know, Senko, whenever he's rediscovering something, or whenever he develops a plan to develop something, he always shows his step-by-step way of getting there with all of the different checkpoints along the way, and how two different technologies combine together to create future technology. And that's what I really loved about this show. Each and every step was broken down, and it really reflects how we do things and how we've done things until this day. You know, I remember just in my lifetime, you know, we used to have really fat TV screens, and now you can get, you know, a flat screen TV. You know, we used to have massive mobile phones, and we've now gone to flat smartphones. So, you know, Senko really captures that sort of ingenuity that we have as human beings. Okay, so I hope you liked that video. If you did, please give us a like and subscribe down below. I really enjoy going through and explaining these videos because it's a great way to learn and refresh your sort of knowledge on conditions like this, or the science behind what we see in the day-to-day sort of entertainment. Now, if there are any other scenes in either movies, animation, TV shows that you'd like me to explain and give a breakdown to, please leave those down in the comments below. But otherwise, I'll see you in the next one. Thanks.